Chalmers and then Sweden by itself are, I would say, leading when it comes to clean tech.
Swedes are really very friendly persons. Like, whenever we ask some question, immediately they will help us.
India, Germany.
In the west coast port of Gothenburg, Sweden's second city, lies the distinguished and world-famous university, Chalmers. Chalmers is ranked by many among the top 100 technological universities in the world. It leads the international community in various fields, advocating an interdisciplinary approach with one common uniting theme of sustainable development.
Students that come to Chalmers, they will find a very engaging environment so that they feel that they are engaged to cross over borders between the different disciplines and also the social output that we have here at the university.
You know that you're from Karen?
The university was founded in 1829 by William Chalmers, who donated some of his fortune for the establishment of an industrial school. He built up his fortune as a director of the Swedish East India Company, whose ships traded across the world. The enterprise was not only lucrative, but also led to trans-global cooperation and development. The university is still keeping this global spirit alive and is constantly breaking uncharted territory in sustainable and environmentally friendly research.
Sustainability has been for many, many years a part of Chalmers. We should always be able to describe what effect and what influence we have on a sustainable future.
Master's courses are in English, allowing students from all over the world to enroll. The quality of education is extremely high, and so naturally are the admission requirements. The university demands that students show initiative and take an active part in the learning process.
It's a very different system of studying, but you learn a lot. Sweden is the best country to study sustainability. They are pioneers here. So I think you can see everywhere and people are very aware.
Many projects are on a global scale, but students are still encouraged to think both locally and independently. Around 40% of students at Chalmers are from other countries, and the university boasts an impressive degree of cooperation with institutions around the world, such as Columbia University in the USA and Tsinghua in China.
They were really, really connected with them, and they helped us really a lot.
And me and Thomas followed as master thesis students doing our master thesis in Tsinghua.
And as a group, we were there to investigate the possibilities to combust waste and sludge in China. Our part was to investigate the fluid dynamics in a certain type of boiler.
And we got to do it both on an industrial boiler down in the south of China at the paper mill. And then we can compare that result to a model that we built in the university.
The university has 8 main areas of research: material science, production, information and communication technology, transport, built environment, nanoscience and nanotechnology, and life sciences and energy. Professor John Liu at the nanoscience department carries out important research.
做一些新的器件的开发和它的系统集成，把这些器件呢用在这个降省耗能源和降低材料损耗等这方面。Chalmers是这个学校有非常好的一个进化室，这个里面已经投资了大概10亿人民币的这么一个进化室，有250套的比较大型的这个做这个光刻和这个电子设备以及微技术上面需要的一些设备。 所以我们这个学校呢，它的这个进化式的设备和它的科研进度是非常好的，在欧洲可以是领先的。
我非常喜欢这边比较安静的一种祥和的一种科研氛围，就是它能够提供给我足够好的一些个人的积累，然后在毕业之后呢，我相信凭着这样的积累，无论是到是回国去找工作，或者是在欧洲继续留下来进行进一步的研究，或者是去世界上别的地方进行一些别的做一些别的事情，都是会非常有帮助的。我觉得学生和导师的平等交换，有利学生的发展。
这我认为是我们Chalmers大学一个特点，而且这个设备非常好，这样更加有利于学生去自己做实验。瑞典人他们有一个可持续发展的一种生活的理念，他们生活不是特别快，然后比较安详，所以说他们有很多的时间可以静下来心来想一想，我们的生活到底要的是什么，然后他们不会因为非常一些功利性的原因，然后去非常急的去做一些可能对环境带来很大问题的事情。 这样的生活态度，这样的思想方式，其实是非常的sustainable，这样可持续发展。
Chalmers has received international exposure and recognition for its numerous environmental research projects.
Chalmers have had for at least 10 years an environmental initiative. There's been a focus on environmental technology and also on environmental research in various different areas. We are working with different types of environmental measurements, remote sensing measurements mostly. The national community, they have realized that shipping and the emissions coming out from shipping is actually an environmental problem. When we fly in an airplane, we try to measure emissions of ships. The main purpose is actually to survey the ship traffic. There's a community of research that is going on towards clean technology. I would say that Chalmers is an excellent place to go. Chalmers and then Sweden by itself are quite, I would say, leading when it comes to clean tech.
Close cooperation with top companies gives the curriculum an invaluable lift. Students get to see science being done at first hand. One example is the development of Volvo into having more sustainable materials.
Some of the research at Chalmers, tools they develop, we actually use at Volvo Cars as the main tools for this simulation field. And one of the great benefits is that we have a very fast communication between the university and Volvo. Almost anyone who makes a master thesis within a company gets good connections and get the good possibility to continue to do research within that area. In my case, I did the master thesis in the same department. I did my PhD degree at the same department. And now I work at the company and I continue to do research at the same department. So you have a good like academic career, although you have a full-time work within the industry. So I think that is something which is quite unique and very important, really.
So what happens to students having completed their studies? Well, according to the number of alumni holding posts as CEOs in Fortune Global 500 companies, Chalmers ranks as first in Sweden and number 16 in Europe.
学校就每年都会有一个那个相当于国内的招聘会一样的形式的一个会，然后在这里就学校就会请来，算在瑞典，甚至在欧洲都非常有名的。
I was doing my master thesis project and it was going really, really well. The firm, they were really interested and they started planning to running prototypes of the offer that we had designed for them. And I guess at a presentation, one of the professors liked what he saw and he approached me and said, "Hey, you know, Marcus, we like people that try to combine real business with sort of an academic approach. Would you like to work for us?"
The innovative environment, of course, not only fosters CEOs and people in high positions, but also a lot of new companies started by the students. There's an innovation department giving students a helping hand in putting their ideas into practice. It's called CSI.
We have students coming from different parts of the world. We have established different kind of future collaborations with them, worked jointly with participants from firms, with students, with researchers, to try to create a community with different kind of people interacting and creating knowledge together. We have very often seminars where we invite participants from the firms. So it's also about opportunities to meet people from firms in this environment here at Chalmers with us.
Chalmers has two campuses, both centrally located and easily accessible. So the city centre is never far away. There's always something happening at the campus. The social calendar is jammed with clubs and associations, concerts and sports, and restaurants and cafes.
在这边更有感触的是那个，就是就像之前说的那个公共设施，真的是我感觉在这边非常的方便。现在学校就提供各种各样的娱乐设施啊。The
top-notch study environment, an international spirit of Chalmers, is carefully nurtured by its high-profile student organisation. The students are given the perfect base from which to develop life-lasting networks and relationships with both people and with the environment.
It's our goal to ensure that every student has a good time, feels at home in Gothenburg, feels welcome and gets a chance to integrate with other cultures and traditions, understand other nationalities and things like that, all when they're having fun. I think that is unique to Chalmers. It fosters whatever interest you have. It gives you the opportunity to be who you are and be proud about it.